Hello friends, this is Supriya. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this video, we will discuss one of the types of cell division in cell biology, that is mitosis or equational cell division. So friends, let's get started. First, let us discuss what is mitosis. Mitosis is a type of cell division in which a parent cell divides into two genetically identical daughter cells, which means both the daughter cells will have same number and same kind of chromosomes as the parent nucleus. So we can also consider it as a process of cell duplication. Now talking about the important features of the mitosis, it occurs in the M phase of the cell cycle, or it is an intermediate phase between the G2 interphase and cytokinesis. It basically involves four stages, that are prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Then mitosis only occurs in somatic cells that do not participate in the production of gametes. Now let us study the mitosis phase in the cell cycle. In this diagram of cell cycle, the portion highlighted in yellow indicates the M phase or mitosis phase. It is a process of cell division that occurs between the G2 interphase of cell development and G1 phase of cell growth. M phase is divided into two stages. Karyokinesis is the first stage and cytokinesis is the second stage. Karyokinesis is the process of nuclear division in which duplicated chromosomes are segregated into daughter nuclei, and it generally involves four sequential stages, that are prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. In cytokinesis, the cell itself divides into two daughter cells by the separation of cytoplasm. In animal cells, cytokinesis occurs via formation of cleavage furrow in the plasma membrane, whereas cytokinesis in plant cell occurs through a cell plate formation at the center of the cell. Now we will discuss the stages of karyokinesis in M phase. Starting with prophase, it is the first stage of karyokinesis that occurs after the S and G2 interphase. During prophase, the condensation of chromosomal material occurs, which forms compact mitotic chromosomes, and these chromosomes contain two chromatids that are combined together at the centromere. The intertwined DNA molecules formed during the interphase cell cycle becomes untangled during the prophase. Centrosomes after duplication during the interphase move towards the opposite poles of the cell. Then centrosomes at the opposite poles radiate esters and spindle fibers. And during this stage, nucleolus completely disappears and nuclear membrane begins to degenerate. Then prometaphase is the stage that falls between the prophase and metaphase. In this stage, complete disintegration of the nuclear membrane occurs and the sister chromatids become free. Then a kinetochore protein develops around the centromere holding sister chromatids, and the kinetochore microtubules from the centrosome at the poles of the spindle attaches to the kinetochores of the centromere. Here you can also see polar microtubules that are not attached to the chromosomes, and these fibers come from each pole and overlap at the spindle midzone. Then metaphase is the stage when the chromosomes align at the equator by forming the metaphase plate. The chromosomes at the spindle equator are attached through the spindle fibers to both poles. After that, during anaphase, the chromosomes at the metaphase plate split and move to the opposite ends. Now here these sister chromatids are referred as daughter chromosomes, and the centromere of these daughter chromosomes is directed towards the pole. Then telophase is the last stage of karyokinesis in which the chromosomes cluster at the opposite spindle poles and a nuclear membrane develops around the clusters of chromosome. This results in the formation of two daughter nuclei. Also during this stage, nucleolus reforms. In M phase, cytokinesis is the second process that divides a parent cell into two identical daughter cells. In animal cells, cytokinesis occurs through the formation of cleavage furrow by the invagination of the plasma membrane. At the site of cleavage furrow, a contractile ring forms, which contains actin and myosin II filaments. And rho A is a protein that directs the assembly and function of a contractile ring. And the phosphorylation of rho A causes contraction of actin and myosin II filaments, that resulting in the formation of cleavage furrow. And this furrow deepens and the cell eventually divides into two daughter cells. Whereas in plant cell, cytokinesis occurs through the cell plate formation at the middle of the cell. A cell plate forms through the assembly of microtubules along with the actin filaments at the vertical plane. Some sac-like structure also fuse with this array of microtubules to form a phragmoplast or a cell plate. And this cell plate ultimately divides a cell into two identical daughter cells. We will end up this video by discussing the significance of mitosis. Mitotic divisions in the meristematic tissues like apical and lateral cambium result in a continuous plant growth. It also plays a significant role in cell repair, as the cells can replace old or dead cells in the upper layer of epidermis, blood cells, etc. with new cells through mitosis. Mitosis generally occurs in diploid cells, but some lower plants can undergo vegetative propagation through mitosis by forming bud-like structures, tubers, rhizomes, etc. Mitosis also maintains genetic stability by producing two genetically identical progenies similar to the parent cell. So friends, this is all for today. To know this topic more in detail, you can visit our official website, that is biologyreader.com. Link is provided in the description box. So if you find this lesson useful, do like, comment, share and subscribe my channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos.